How you doing, Paul from Deutsch Auto Parts? Today we're here with Charles from Humble Mechanic, and we're going to be doing an install on a fuel pump for a 2.0 TSI engine.
All right, for this particular DIY, we're going to be replacing the high pressure fuel pump on a 2-liter TSI engine. This is the high pressure fuel pump, and there's only really a few tools that you're going to need for this job, and that's going to be a T30 Torx, a number 5 Allen, a 17 millimeter box wrench, a 19 millimeter box wrench, a pair of hose clamp pliers, and I like to always have a screwdriver, a pocket screwdriver, and a flashlight available. Now you will be opening the fuel system up on this job, so I also recommend wearing some gloves and having a shop rag available to clean up any fuel you're gonna spill. Hey everybody, Charles for HumbleMechanic.com. Paul had asked me to come out today and help him shoot some video on replacing a high pressure fuel pump on a TSI engine. And this is Paul's car, and I'm gonna go over the procedure to replace the high pressure fuel pump, which is located right here. It's a pretty straightforward job. I'm gonna take a few things off that you may not necessarily have to. It just opens up the engine compartment a little and gives us some more room to work. The basic tools that you need are gonna be a T30, a number 5 Allen, a 17 millimeter wrench, and some hose pliers to pull this rubber hose off. This rubber hose right here is probably the trickiest part of the entire job. All right, so like I said, I'm gonna take the airbox out. It just opens up the engine bay a little bit more. I'm gonna show you how to do that. First, disconnect the airflow meter and lay this connector to the side. Depending on where you wanna take the back hose clamp off is up to you. You can take it off here. I actually like to take it off of this one. Like that. I'm gonna take the front of the airbox off. There's three tabs that you just need to pull up. Take off the secondary air filter pipe. Some cars don't have this, so obviously if your car doesn't have that, you don't need to worry about it. There's one screw that needs to be undone between the airbox and the vehicle battery. I'm gonna release this out of the front, give it a good pull. Take this piece off the airbox induction pipe. Set that to the side. Now, one thing you want to be careful is don't pull this straight up. You need to kind of massage it out. If you pull it straight up, you're going to break a coolant line. You'll see once I get it out how much more room we got to work. So there's the entire airbox out. I'm going to lay that to the side. Now you can see we got a whole bunch more room to get to this high pressure fuel pump. Okay, now that we're looking a little bit tighter in on the high pressure fuel pump, I can show you exactly what I'm gonna do. It's really only two bolts that hold this pump in, one hard fuel line and one soft fuel line. Now you notice I have these paper towels tucked up under here. You are gonna lose a little bit of fuel undoing this bottom line. So that's something you wanna make sure you take into account. Make sure you're being safe with what you do. You don't wanna get a mouth or eyeball full of fuel. Okay, so I'm gonna be taking off the two T30 screws first. Now these screws are gonna be fairly tight, so you wanna make sure to get the T30 set in there properly. Now, on something like this that is actually spring-loaded, I like to take them out a little at a time on each screw. And before I get it all the way out, a little trick is going to be to crack the fuel line down here at the bottom loose first. And this is where your 17 millimeter wrench comes in. Again, this fuel is under a little bit of pressure. You can bleed the pressure off if you want, but if you don't, just make sure you're being safe. And you'll see we lose a little bit of fuel here. And that just after cracking it loose, usually you can just spin it right off like that. I'm going to also disconnect it. Move the connector out of the way. and then we just run the screws out all the rest of the way. All right, now that we have both screws out and the hard fuel line off, we're going to take this rubber fuel line off. And with the right hose clamp pliers, it's actually not that hard of a thing to do. Pull the clamp back. Now, like I said in the beginning, this is probably the most challenging part right here. If you have some lubrication, you can spray, give it a little spray, and that'll loosen up the hose a little bit. And then I actually like to pull this out all the way. And try not to tear Paul's hose up. This is why I like to take the high pressure pump out first. As you can see, I'm kind of pulling and twisting at the same time. Now that it's separated a little, we can pull it off the rest of the way. And there you have one TSI high pressure fuel pump. Now, one thing while you have that high pressure fuel pump out, you want to check is the follower. The easiest way to get that out is to take a magnet and just kind of ease it out, just like that. And inspect the roller and the keyway. This one can only go in one way, so there's no need to worry about orientation. Now, even though you're pulling this out and inspecting it, this one doesn't have the wear problems like some of the older FSI engines do, but you're already most of the way there. You might as well go ahead and pull it out and inspect it. And if it looks good, just drop it right back in the way you had it. All right, this is our old pump, and this is what a new pump looks like. Now, you'll notice that the old pump has this fitting on the end, and the new pump doesn't. So that's something you're gonna need to transfer from your old pump onto your new pump. And that's very easy. It's just a 19 millimeter bolt head. Just get a 19 millimeter wrench, take this off, and reinstall it on the new one. All right, basically, the installation is pretty much the same as the removal. The one special note I will say is make sure you get this set properly. This is very soft and it's easy to cross thread. I know that because I've done it. So just take your time installing it. And much like when I was taking it out, I like to run these two T30s in a little bit at a time to prevent tweaking the pump at all. Another good tip while you're doing this is, before you tighten this pump down all the way, start your fuel, your high pressure fuel line on that fitting. It makes it a little easier while you have some wiggle in the pump and on the fitting. I don't tighten this all the way till I have the fuel pump tight. We install our low pressure fuel line and clamp. Plug our pump in, reinstall the airbox, and we're good to go. All right, our last step is to go ahead and put the airbox back on. Now, I don't generally separate them when I'm taking the whole thing out. You can, it does make it a tiny bit easier, but if you just pull up a little bit on this coolant pipe, you can actually reinstall it fairly easily. Just like that, give it a push. There is one screw that has to be screwed in, and that's a number 5 Allen. That's snug. Go ahead and plug our mass airflow meter in. Put our wire back. Put our clamp on. Just like that. The last pieces of our ducting. Our secondary air filter pipe. The cover. And we install the engine cover. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the video.